silences the possibility of a point for Spaziri. It's now 10-4. And that. And in terms of the men's match, we'll give you a little bit of an update as we just got up here in the booth here in Northeast Sports Network. Dana Soundtree defeated Kamal Wumberbatch 3-1 in the number 9. And also came up with a victory, 3-0. That was Nathan Cohen, who defeated Ahmad Ismail, 3-0 again in that number 5's match. On time, incidentally, it's the ball point awarded to James Flynn. Gentlemen using their backhand now to their advantage. Now going to the short game is Flynn. He recovers. Fisherov does so himself. And now to the back corner they go again. Excellent rally started by these two. Of match number 2 for your viewing pleasure, number 4 of the day, in terms of the men's squash matchup between Trinity and the University of Pennsylvania. Excellent rally between these two gentlemen as that ball is played to the back left-hand corner for some backhand service between these two right-handed favored squashers. He's getting support from his teammates here. Flynn trying to also calm himself down and keep this match even. Seen some of the best rallies today in this game alone. Both competitors know what this game really means for their teams. And of course, as competitors, they want it for themselves as well. And just as we were talking about great rallies, here's one for the. Glenn was carrying a lot of good momentum from game 4 after winning early on, but now it looks like this is pressure off. At the last 3 points. Strong competition between these two, extending each other from left to right. Quick stutter step from James Flynn. Using the short, you can be insufferable for your opponent. And that's what Muhammad just did right there. Absolutely wonderful job to recover. Second time on that one, and there it is for Mohamed Sharaf. And so Mohamed Sharaf picks up the first match victory for Trinity on the day.